Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Big Yak Monthly Cup. Today is weekly qualifier number 3 of the month of September. We have the same format as usual. We also, as always, we have very interesting maps. We have a lot of gamers on server 1, but also on server 2 and 3. And yeah, in case you're here for the first time, I'm going to quickly explain you how it works. Basically, I downloaded 15 maps from Trackmania Exchange, randomized maps that are unknown, so people don't know what they are about to play. And on each of these maps, people have one warm-up, and then there is going to be 3 life rounds in which people can win points. Basically, people collect points then over the different maps, and at some point they will reach the point limit, which is 6,969 points, a very nice number. And once they reach that, they only have to win one more round in order to close out the finalist mode. It basically works similar to the Bonk Cup. I guess many of you know that one. And yeah, I would say we're gonna start. Hope you guys are ready. Hope the players are ready. We have over 100 players on server 1. Alright, of course, what I have to explain. There is a few things that I have to explain. So first of all, the way this month's Big Yak Monthly Cup works is that each month we have 3 styles that I randomized beforehand. The styles this week are Speed Fun, Fragile, and Slow-Mo. These are the styles that are randomized. And for each of the 3 styles, I randomized 5 maps. So we have basically 5 maps of each of the 3 styles and 15 maps in total. And this is map 1 here. Map 1 is Summer 2024 Cleaned, an altered Nadeo map. But yeah, this is the first map of the day. And this is actually a map which had the tech Speed Fun. This is one of the Speed Fun maps. Don't ask me why, but it's basically the current 01 map in the cleaned altered version. Cleaned basically means that all of the effect blocks are deleted. So for example, in the case of this map, there usually is a booster here, right? And that one is deleted. It also deletes water and all effect blocks basically are deleted. So this map is not very changed, actually. It is pretty much only the first booster missing. And for some reason, this was tagged as Speed Tech. So not Speed Tech, Speed Fun. So this is literally one of the Speed Fun maps. Don't ask me why, please. Anyway, we're going into the first round. Let's see what people are gonna cook. Ach yeah, very importantly, car switches are also deleted. So we don't have desert car on this map. Very interesting. So it is full stadium now. Never mind, I forgot it. Yeah, whole different car. Yeah, chill. All right, we have apparently Bleff winning the first round with a 25.32. Very nice. I actually have a good time on this map because I played this altered campaign. Obviously, I played it, of course. I am the altered Nadeo enjoyer. I obviously played this one. So I guess people will like this map more because, you know, not many people enjoy the new cars. And here, you literally don't have the desert car. So I guess people like this more than the original version. So I guess people are not too mad about this one. So let's go on to Bleff maybe. He won round 1. Doesn't look like he will win round 2. He has very low speed. What about Intax? Intax was really good at today's Cup of the Day, and he also looks pretty juicy in this round here. And it seems like he's winning, because in the ending there is not a lot happening. People just have to air brake, make sure to not miss the finish, and there we go. Intax with a round win, 25.3. Pretty good time. Not as good as Bleff's winning time, but still a 0.3. A few really good players missing. I think there is none of the OK Boys playing today. Because Lars is doing the challenge with Scrappy. Marius is celebrating his birthday today. Chris is playing. Okay, never mind. We have Chris from the OK Boy section. Hello, Kanadi. Yeah, sorry, Chris. I miss you. Okay, so we at least have Chris. Nice. So hopefully Chris is going to carry the OK Boy flag today. But yeah, let's see. Final round on map number 1. Let's maybe follow Heath. Heath is already qualified to the monthly final. He is pretty much only playing for fun today. But of course, he can possibly deny his opponents, which could be, you know, also worth something. So let's see. Looking good for Heath here. That is a 6th place, 7th place. Yeah, solid position here by Heath. I think very simple first map to start with. Also a map of the Speed Fun category for today. Arguably the easiest category. So I think a very chill start for everybody. Nobody can complain too much about this one. But I can tell you one thing, this is not the last Altered Nadeo map that we will see for today. There is actually 5 maps from the Altered Nadeo category today. And we go over to the first Fragile map. Training 15 Magnet is one of the 5 Fragile maps that I rolled. Because, yeah, as you can see, there is Fragile in the start. And this map is very stupid. I can tell you that much. Obviously, I also have a time here because I also played this altered campaign. But this map is very stupid. I can tell you that much. This one is very, very stupid because, yeah, it's basically the training map. The training campaign maps in general are very dumb. You all know that. But now with Magnet. And, yeah, we basically have press forward start. You don't have to do the left-right. You only have to survive this jump. You have to air brake and you need to be lucky with the fragile. That is the map, ladies and gentlemen. Plus, plus. I hope you guys enjoy this one. Banger map. Well, this is basically a full luck map. The only thing you have to do is time your air brake perfectly for the jump. That is literally it. So I wish you the best of luck, guys. There is almost nothing you have to do here. Literally one input. So let's see who is the best air breaker in the chat. It is Kanchika. No, never mind. Not Kanchika. It lagged. It is JG Firelord. And look at this. The entire top 8 within 6 thousandths of a second. And they missed my they missed my PB by 1 thousandth. Isn't that amazing, guys? Banger. Plus plus map, guys. This is competitive gaming here. But as of course, maps like this can of course occur in the Big Yak Monthly Cup because maps are randomized, and that just means, yeah, it can be random maps which are lucky or full skill maps or basically anything. So let's see what is the next winning time. It is a 0.42. Okay, very good time by Sinks here. And then we have a 5-man tie. There were 5 people with a 0.437. Nice. GG, guys. Very good. Amazing. Okay, up to the final round of this map. What a nice one. Banger map, guys. Full skill. But of course, maps like this shuffle around the leaderboard quite a little bit. And what is... Oh my god, look at this. The 437 is actually crazy close. Look at that, guys. That is insane. Yeah, okay. This was map 1. Map 2. Banger map, guys. Banger map. This definitely allowed some unusual people to also win a lot of points. Because it was literally only one input that you had to do. Okay, going on to the next map, which is called Wavy Curves. And this was... I think this was also a speed fun map. And this one, I tested it, is really bad, guys. Really, really bad map. I can tell you to watch out after the ending. After the looping in the ending, the end of this map is really fucking dog shit. So be aware. Be aware. I'm not gonna spoiler why. I was kicked. Fantastic. Kicked from my own competition. Okay, I'm joining. I'm joining. There I am. I forgot that the spectators have a different password. My bad. I'm there again. Hello. Okay, but yeah, this is the map here. You basically have these kind of tubes that you have to follow. And then in the ending, you have a looping. And the looping is really shit. The looping is really fucking bad. Because the players will probably see it. Hello. When you do the looping in the middle, you will overjump the reactor. But you need the reactor to finish. It is really fucking dumb. The ending is really bad. So I guess many people will fail it. But let's see. I'm interested to see what's happening. I'm not sure if I ever saw ice on the server here. So let's see how he's gonna do. Good luck, have fun. So let's see what people are gonna cook. We have a roof fit in the beginning. Oh, ice? Not with the greatest jump here. Maybe he forgot to air brake. I don't know. Then we have the right turn. Very good line here by ice. Never mind, never mind. Very bad line by ice. Not good at all. What is Arpa doing? Arpa getting the tube. Nice. Let's see, he is in the middle of the field roughly, dodging the obstacle, and now we have the looping. And now this part is important, because if you do the looping the normal way, you will overjump the reactor, which is not good. But yeah, Arpa doing it safe, 15th place for him. Nicolas with a 31.7, nice time actually, beating the offer time, very good. This guy going backwards, GigaChat, purple also finishing, nice. But that happens, look, that's what happens when you jump. You can, like, miss the finish. And that is not good, of course. You don't want to miss the finish. So, yeah, very tricky ending. There is basically two ways. Either you risk it or you... Yeah, do not. This is how it looks when you risk it and you make it. But you can also just release or break for the reactor, of course. But overall, still pretty close. Nobody running away in points. But yeah, seems like people don't like the map too much. Fair enough, though. Fair enough. Okay, let's follow Tarpor. Parkour, not sure if he's streaming as well. And I'm also not sure, did Tarpor ever join one of the Big Yak Monthly Cups? I don't know, actually. Maybe he did, maybe he didn't. No clue. But Tarpor also usually quite good at fast learning, especially on weird maps. So let's see how he's gonna do today. We still have a lot of weird maps coming up. But let's see, what about this one? He is going for the risk. Is he gonna get up into the finish? No, he missed it. Okay, that was really unfortunate. Valegen also playing. Valegen, a very good player. He literally just joined. So he missed out on the first two maps, some three maps almost. Okay, one more round. Semifying actually with a win on that map. That is really nice for semifying. Where is he actually? I don't even see him, so he is quite far behind. But with those 500 points, he definitely caught up a little bit. So let's maybe spectate Purple. Purple, our German amigo here. Let's see how he's gonna do. The start is looking solid. 0.4 away. Is he gonna risk the ending though? That is the question. Is he gonna go for the risk or is he gonna try to save it? Let's see, let's see, let's see. It looks like he's going for the risk. Is he gonna make it? Yes! And going up into 6th place. Okay. Very good, actually. Very good performance by Purple. Nice. Plisky, in the meantime, going into 1st place. And we have another All Turd Nadeo map. Ladies and gentlemen, it is All Turd Nadeo Day. This is all... literally, 3 out of 4 maps today were All Turd Nadeo. Amazing. And it is Winter 2023-03 Fragile. Yep, another Fragile map. The thing is, the Fragile is not really having a big effect here. Unless you crash, of course. But there isn't really any jumps. Today, we really have a lot of them, to be honest. Because, like, a lot of the Fragile and Slow-Mo maps are just All Turd Nadeo maps. But yeah, it is this map. The only part where you could get Fragile is basically this drop. So you want to make sure to land clean here to not get the Fragile. Other than that, it is pretty much the exact Nadeo map. And nothing else. So yeah, people who possibly hunted this map back in the days perhaps have a bit of an advantage. But let's see. Let's see, let's see, let's see. Who do we spectate? Sings had a really good start. Where is Sings? A good warm-up, I mean. Sings had a good warm-up. Will he also have a good life round? We will see. Clean air brake, looking good. Oh, but I think he got fragile a little bit. This is not looking too good for him. Yeah, he definitely got fragile. You can clearly see how his car is refusing to accelerate. And we have Toto with a win. Toto with a point 51. Snappy with a 52. Overall, once again, pretty close. The entire top 8 only within 0.3 of a second. Not bad. Holy moly. Okay, Plisky. Actually looking really solid. 180 points in the lead. Let's see how he's gonna do on map 2 of... round 2 of this map here. A clean low jump. Is he having fragile effect? It looks like he is a little bit slow, so probably not gonna get the greatest amount of points, but he is surviving, and in the ending, in order to get finalists, you wanna have consistently good results. You don't have to win every round, but you just need to be consistently in the higher positions. That's the most important thing. Let's maybe follow Patenfechter. Patenfechter had one really good round so far, but overall, not too high up in the rankings. He's in the 20s. So let's see, what is he gonna cook? Oh, does he have fragile? Hard to tell. It's in general very hard to tell what's happening here, because some people have fragile, some others don't. And it just looks like some are, you know, accelerating more than others do. And a 0.29 by Lynx. That is actually a really good time. Holy moly, a 0.2. By far the best time we have seen on this map. Crazy. And yeah, we go on to the next map. And we have another altered Nadeo map. This is an... In the way. We have another altered Nadeo map, guys. Ain't no way. Why are they all coming up in a row? Why is it all of them in a row, man? This is the last one, for real. Trust me, guys. I am so sorry, but it's just... It's just what it is. I cannot do anything about it. The randomizer randomize. What's the randomizer wants to randomize? Did that make sense? I'm not sure. But look at this fancy camera, eh? Holy shit. Look at this. Look at the racers. We have a really cool reactor soup that you can go for in the ending. Some people did it, some others didn't. So that one could be decisive in the ending. But let's see. We are going in. We are going in. Let's follow... let's follow Purple. Let's follow Purple. Of course, you do not want to crash here. Otherwise, you might get the fragile effect. And that one is basically gonna limit your steering and acceleration a lot. It seems like purple didn't get it. Let's go for the ending. Is purple gonna go for the reactor soup? Insta airbreak here and soup! You see how some people are like yeeting in front? That is basically what I was talking about. So you can go on the left, get airtime, and then insta brake. And when the car is basically in this position, so the front up and the back down, and you have reactor up, you get like a speed boost. And look at this, guys. We actually have very close races once again. Of course, the map is not too complicated. But yeah, still cool to see that many people have figured it out. But of course, also, like, in theory, many people know the map. Like, many people played the Winter 2023 campaign. So, yeah. Oh, now purple crashed in the start. And that means he has Fragile. So he is fully in the mud. So let's skip a bit further ahead. Jan van Achtern also with a good performance this round, getting the soup, getting it really good, and overtaking at least like 10 other players. Really good. Holy shit. We go next. Let's see. Another round. Final round of this map already. We have TV King in first. Oh. We have Nicolas in second. Let's see what Nicolas is gonna cook this round. Oh, not the greatest soup by Nicolas. You see how you saw how some people souped ahead of him. But overall, still good points for him. We have a lot of good players. Oh my god, look how close it is. Heath in first, Scandier second, Sano third, Intax fourth, Intax fifth, Tarpo fifth, Matt Hyper in sixth, Smiley Bob, and then also Jan. Crazy, very close races here. And look at this TV King with very low amounts of points, of course. And we still, wow, look how close it is. Holy shit. Dude, look at this, the entire top 10 within 300 points. And we have... guys, there is another Alter Tadeo map that I forgot about. There is another... Why are... There is really not that many. Look at the list. Slash list. There is... There is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There is 5. And we get all of them in a row. 5 out of 15. Come on, there is really not that many. Like, there is really not that many. This is for real the last one. This is for real the last one, guys. F-O-F-O. This is the last one. For real now. This is for real the last one, guys. Skip? What do you mean skip? Why skip? This is broken, you get... Oh, skip, it's broken. Okay, I'm gonna skip. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna skip. Yeah, I'm skipping. Okay, next map. Oh, okay. This one is really hard, guys. Okay, so there is basically... Okay, so I have to do some explanations. There is an abuse that you can do when there is a slow-mo map and you play with low FPS, like you, if you lock it to 20 or 30 FPS, you can sometimes skip the slow-mos. It is super, super weird. Don't question it. I have no idea why. Anyway, we have a map which is called DTC Ghost Blocks. And this one is very, very dank. This is probably the hardest map. Probably the hardest map that is on the server today. So this one is really, really dank. So get ready for this one. This one is crazy. So let's see. Who do we follow? Valegen is driving. Okay, the spectating is going to be awkward here because the camera is shit. Ach du Scheiße. Can I please get a proper camera? Oh my god, the camera is shit. Ain't no way. This is the entire cam- This is what I can show you today. Fantastic. Ain't no way. But yeah, it's basically a lot of up and down, magnet, XDD, reactor, looping. This is a very crazy map, guys. This is very, very crazy. But it is respawnable. It is standing respawnable. I tested it. So it is drivable. It is hard, but it's drivable. But yeah, we will have to spectate in camera 7 because, yeah, the game is a little bit yek. Alright, we're going in. Let's see. Let's follow Valegen. Valegen going up. Oh, I actually have a normal camera. Nice. Then we have Magnet. We go to the right. We go up. Now we have even more reactor into Magnet. Now outside Magnet turn into a right turn into a left turn. Staying straight here, now looping to the left, going very far down, small zigzagu, Valegen with a small touch, doesn't matter too much, then going back to going straight, now up and now to the left, bit of a jump scare, have to react very quickly there, down left, now up again to the left into a magnet, Once again, direction change. Very far jump here. People are surviving it. Looking good for Verlegen so far. Then we have a finish jump and a right turn into... Not the finish yet. We have another jump here. More magnet. And now plastic wall ride. And then there should be the finish. I think. Never mind. No finish yet. Where's the finish? Verlegen had to respawn. Most chaotic map ever. Where's the finish? There's the finish. Yeah. A very normal track. This time the rounds are not that close. Look at that. There is a 10-second gap in the top 8. Very dank map, very hard, but everything is standing respawnable, guys. So I picked it. It is hard, but it's drivable, guys. Hard, but drivable. It is the hardest map of today, I think. Why is Marantis so fast? Jesus Christ. Definitely understanding the map the best. So I'm gonna spectate him so that we can see a proper POV here. So I hope the camera is gonna be somewhat normal, please. So let's see. Is he gonna survive again? Is he gonna show us a clean run? Oh, small magnet soup here. Pretty crazy. Grabbing the magnet here. Marantir GPS. Right, left. Now the looping where you go very far down. Surviving the zigzag. Very clean line. Mashallah, keeping a lot of speed into the left here. Holy moly. He knows the map better than anyone else. Jesus Christ. Look, he is pulling ahead. That is some crazy performance by Marantir. Going into the looping here. Now the right turn where you have to grab... Oh, he survived. That was really close. He barely even made the jump. Getting overtaken by 2-3 players, but not too big of an issue. He is still in third. Considering he full stopped, that is okay still, I would say. That is okay. But yeah, Blisky now also with a 50-second time. Pretty solid. Pretty solid. Can't complain. Marantir in second even. Holy moly, he even sniped ice. Okay, final round. Let's maybe follow Blisky. He did perform really well. Oh, nein, I have the wrong camera. Fuck. I skipped the cam change. Nein, the camera is cursed. Ain't no way, little bro. Ah, fuck. Okay, camera in the mud, guys. We go, cam 7. Let's see what's happening. Marantir going into the looping. Being followed by Heath. We go down, we go up. We go into the overloop. Now the downhill wall ride. Very crazy map. By the way, this map was part of the speed fun category. I think. Yeah, must have been because there's no fragile and no slow-mo. So yeah, very, very dank here. Now we have the looping into another wall ride. Into what's happening? I forgot. Never mind. Finish. I'm so confused, guys. I'm just confused. But it's Marantir here with a 47-second time. That is actually insane. That is a really... cooked time. Holy moly, aim. Okay, next map. It is called Eclipse. And this one, what was this map again? I think this one was pretty simple. Not gonna lie. This was a pretty simple map, if I recall correctly. I'm not sure. What was this map from? Was it also Speed Fun? I think this was also a map of the Speed Fun category. We have multiple paths here. Purple definitely chose the wrong one. There's basically only one that is good, which is skipping the ramp and going insta-left. That is the path that you should take. Skip the ramp and insta-left here. Very simple map. And apparently there is a forced camera free. Yeah, hello? Yeah, nice. I didn't notice that while I was testing, guys. Oh, look at this. There's a risky route in the start. Holy moly. Look at this, how fast it is. Risky route in the start. Crazy. Oh, Purple missing the jump. Verlegen with a good one here. Okay, wait a second. What is happening in the start? I completely did not see that. Wait, what can you do there? I didn't see that while testing. Oh, look at this. You can go straight. And there's a red boost. Aha, okay, okay, okay. Yeah, that is quite dank. That is quite dank, guys. Holy moly. Interesting. Very, very interesting. All right. Okay, yeah, Blisky staying in the lead. Skandir is chasing, though. I think, or let's maybe spectate Tarpor. Tarpor had the best time in round one. So let's see. Does he know about the start? What do you even have to do? Oh, you have to do a release, though. Oh, you have to do a release. Okay, it is not free. You have to do a release. You see, so many people crashed it. I think Intax, yeah, Intax easily gonna win this round. Hey, Intax had good speed. Huh? Wait, is the map not respawnable? Yeah, okay, I didn't test the respawn on this one, because, like, if you crash here, you get the red boost, you crash, and you go with a crash into this checkpoint. Ah, because there is a risky finish. Oh my god, what the hell? Huh? Ach so. There is a risky finish. Yeah, hello? I didn't see that. I thought, like, yeah, how would anybody ever standing respawn there? Yeah, okay. I didn't think about that. So I thought, like, yeah, nobody is gonna have to standing respawn there. No need to test it. But there is actually a standing respawn. Okay, very chaotic things happening today again. Holy moly. Okay, let's spectate a little bit further back. Cilantro from Mexico is actually looking pretty good here. Not going for the risky, but a 47th place. Not too bad. Not too bad. In the meantime, we actually have the scenario now that Skandir could reach the finalist. Skandir could get into finalist mode, and we have a very interesting map here, which is called FabLol 900 by Fabnia. And this is one of the Fragile maps. It has Fragile in the start, but I can tell you, Fragile is not really... It doesn't really matter here. Like, you just want to make sure to not crash. The idea is, on this map, we have three laps, and you have to go on the outside. You have to get a nice outside line, and when you have that, you just have to steer, basically. You just have to full steer left when you get the line. Very simple. Actually quite complicated. Not as easy as it looks like. So look at this. Skandir basically just has to steer here. Very interesting map here. Very interesting map. It's gonna be interesting on, you know, who's gonna close it out here. IMO, a very good map. Very good map if you ask me. Well, let's see. Who's it gonna be? Skandir with a good start. Of course, you have to get the gear first of all. That is very important. And Fredwolf, look at this. Look at this line Fredwolf has. You just have to steer now. Obi Boy, also good line. And look at this. Just steer. Oh, Fredwolf, maybe with the snipe on Obi Boy. Fredwolf with the overtake. Nice line. And Fredwolf with the snipe. Never mind, we have one more lap. I forgot. Wait, Verlegen and Fredwolf with the touch. It's Snappy now in first. Plisky might overtake. We have the closest race. And it is Plisky. 2,000 ahead of Snappy. Yeah, look at this, guys. Exciting racing. Very exciting racing. IMO, a good map. So let's see. Fredwolf once again. So we're starting in third gear. Now in fourth gear, but you still need to get into fifth. So fifth gear has now been reached. Oh, Fredwolf with a touch. That is really bad. Purple also with a touch. Where's Skandir? Skandir also not too far ahead. Where's Jan? Ah, Jan also behind. Okay, I don't know how to spectate someone, but Jan, look at this line by Jan overtaking a lot of players here. But in the ending, it is actually, who is it? Tarpor. Tarpor with a 30.5 winning the round. Nice time. Patenfechter in second and Snappy in third. Okay, final round here already. Let's see. Ice currently chasing Tarpor in the rankings. You can also do a nose slide in the start here. I think Ice also did it, and Ice looking pretty juicy in this round. Getting the gear, and now it's a neck-in-neck race. Look at that. We still have two laps to go. Or is it the last lap already? No, there's one more to go. Ice looking good, but not looking the best. Oh, now with a small touch. Tarpor fighting for the first place against Sings. Who's going to be the one winning the round? It is Sings with a 30.6, but Tarpor again with a juicy performance. Holy moly, eh. Dude, the races today are insane. Not gonna lie. We go on to the next map. And the next map is called Hobo Love ETS by Lingo is Hot. And I think, if I remember correctly, Bleff has a record. No, Fredwolf. Wait, this is Fredwolf's map? Fredwolf knows this map. No way. And there is one thing that I can tell you about this map. There is a strat that you can do. And TV King is doing it. You see what I mean? Some people are smart. Some people are smart. But yeah, the ending is also somewhat tricky here. I can tell you that much. The ending is not easy. You bump up here into the water. Peng, turn around. And look at this. Barely anyone is getting the water. Everybody going for the standing respawn. And then you also have a finish jump, which is not too easy because you can overjump, I think. But yeah, this is the map. So we have a little bit of a thing you can do here. No? You know what I mean? I don't want to spoil it. And then the tricky water turnaround. But yeah, Fred Wolf is saying, this is my map, but you built years ago. So perhaps not the biggest disadvantage or like advantage for him. But yeah, not too many people going for the Trickster at the start. Croxy semifying nice, TV King Sano and Hagen figured it out. Croxy going for the slow strat and getting the turnaround. Very nice, but nice getting it even better. He's getting it really nice. Croxy only getting it nice. Is it nice who's gonna win the round? Yes. Okay, so Fred Wolf officially not overpowered on this one. Also, why the hell was Fred Wolf called Lingo is hot on this one? I have a lot of questions, but anyway. Okay. Oh my god, look at this. Tarpor and Ice could both get finalists now. The finalists, or like the point limit, is 6,969, because you know why. And yeah, they both could reach it. They just need to get, you know, somewhat good points, and they will easily be in. Oh, Ice risking it. Why is he risking it? Ice might be in the mud. What about Tarpor? Tarpor standing respawning, but Tarpor should be fine. He just needs 54 points. Is he gonna get 54 points? It does look like it. Yes, Tarpor is finalist, but Ice actually with the very unnecessary risk. With that, Ice needs one more round to get into finalist. Very not so smart move by Ice, but yeah, doesn't have to mean anything. We will see. For Tarpor could possibly close it out now, and with that, you know, qualify to the monthly final, which is of course everyone's goal here, because the monthly final. Nice one, Tarpor. Banger. Absolute banger of a finals attempt. Oh my god, that was so bad. Nice. Oh my god, where's Ice again? Come on, Ice, you need 50 points. Ice, you need to finish with solid points. Okay, getting the turnaround. Can Ice still make it? He needs 59 points. How many points is he getting? 80. Okay. Lucky for Ice. Kinda lucky for Ice. Ice is now also finalist. The others are still a little bit away. And we go on to the next map. It is called Kiki 113's Campaign 18. And this is a pretty proper map. Probably the most proper map of the day. I am not sure what style it is. Is it speed fun? I'm not entirely sure. It is probably a speed fun map. But I'm not entirely sure. There might also be a slow-mo here. I don't know. Either speed fun or slow-mo. I don't know. But this is probably the most skillful map we had so far today. Very good map. Very good map here. So let's see. Let's see the warm-up out of Ice, his perspective. So what's gonna happen here? Left turn. Oh, missing the checkpoint. Very mean placement. Purple is getting it. So let's follow the rest of the warm-up on, you know, his POV. We have a cruise control into wet tires, into blah, blah, blah. A lot of things happening. Then we have a wall ride into a right turn. Overall, basically a plastic speed kind of map. Now we have reactor boost into a reset, possibly a speed slide that you can do. Then a plastic wall ride into another plastic wall ride. And we also have a risky finish, I can tell you. Let's see how many people will find it. Ah, purple didn't see. I think purple saw it on the very last second. But there is a risky finish on the right, before the red boost. Kinda hidden. So yeah, very skillful map. Let's see, I think Ice has a good chance here. I'm not sure if this is the best map for Tarpor. Because Tarpor is rather good at the more dank stuff. But let's see, I don't wanna... yeah, look at this. I maybe should have shut up, because Tarpor is currently in the lead. Holy fuck. Tarpor cooking. Oh my god, Tarpor really cooking. Okay, I take it back. Sorry, Tarpor. In this wall ride, you wanna go very high. And then low to get, you know, a nice line. But look at this. The only one to deny right now, it seems like, is Marijntje. Oh, but look at this. Marijntje had an insane speed. Marijntje might overtake here. It's gonna be about the ending. Marijntje is the only one to deny Tarpor's victory. Who is gonna make it? Is it Tarpor? Is it Marijntje? What's gonna happen? We have the risky finish. Marijntje doesn't know. And it is Tarpor winning because Marijntje is actually clueless. That is crazy. GG to Tarpor. Dude, Tarpor winning the finalist. Holy shit. Okay, Tarpor. Insane performance by him. Winning against so many insane players. That is crazy. Good job, Torpor. But yeah, with that, Marainte could now suddenly have a good chance. And is Marainte qualified already? I don't think he is, right? No, Marainte is not qualified, so he could be the second duchy to close it out now. Holy moly. Okay, what is gonna happen? What is gonna happen? I'm looking forward to this round. Marainte with a... Okay, Marainte in the mud. What about the other finalists? What about Fredwolf? Fredwolf also a little bit in the mud. What about Ice? Okay, Ice. Ice is in the fight. He is fighting against Heath. So we have now two Frenchies battling after we had two duchies. Oh, but Heath with a solid lead and also pretty good speed. So I think he should be able to close it out. But he is not finalist, of course. Oh, really good finish by Ice. Is it enough? Whoa, what a nice try by Ice. Holy moly. Really inside line, but it is not enough, man. Holy moly. A close, close race, though. Really close race. Nice try by Heath here. By Ice, but also by Heath, of course. Okay, with that, the finalist Fiesta can officially begin. Jan getting into finalist, Skandir and Plisky as well. Nice. Very nice. That's what we want to see. We want to see a lot of finalists closing it out against each other. We have one more round here, and this is probably the most skillful map we have had so far in the entirety of Big Egg Monthly Cup. So, yeah. This map, literally nobody can complain. Like, everybody voting minus minus here. Yek. So let's see. Final round here. What is gonna happen? Who is gonna be the one winning the final round? We have a lot of people with a good start. The race is on. Look at that. There is so many people close to each other. A lot of riskers. Some people dying. It is again Marainte here. The player who already had a really good first round fighting. But he is being chased by Heath. And also by Jan. And Marainte and Jan are finalists. Heath isn't. Who is gonna get the best ending? He's risking too much. Who is it gonna be? It is Marainte winning. Marainte with the second place. And with that, Marainte also qualifying. The second duchy. Holy moly, eh. The duchies are cooking. Nice. One thing that I have to talk about, which we didn't talk about at all yet. The top three of each weekly qualifier are instantly gonna qualify to the monthly final, of course. But then we will also play out the fourth and the fifth finalist today. Very important. So after the top three finishes, we still have two more people who can close out finalist mode. And those fourth and fifth place, they will get a huge amount of points towards the monthly leaderboard. Fourth place is gonna get 15,000 points and fifth place 10,000 points. And with that, they can win a lot of points and possibly have a better chance at qualifying. And what do I see here? Is there a shortcut in the start? There is a shortcut in the start. You can cut here, go to the checkpoint and respawn, and I think it's faster. This is a slow-mo map, by the way, because we have, yeah, a slow-mo here, as you can see. But the map is still pretty normal, to be honest. Like, very shit, very, very, very bad, but drivable. But yeah, so 4th place is gonna win 15,000 points, and 5th place, 10,000 points. And as you can see in the leaderboard, 15,000 points is worth a lot. So for example, Croxy here in qualifier number 2, previous qualifier, he got 4th, so he won 15,000 points. And with that, he is looking really good in the leaderboard. And yeah, other than that, everybody who reaches finalist mode without closing it out is winning 7,500 points. And then the rest of the players will win the amount of points they had when the match ended. So for example, in case the match would end now and Intax has this amount of points, this is also the amount of points he would win onto the leaderboard. So let's see, we have multiple people going for the cut, and the cut is indeed faster. And one of the people going for the cut is Jan. Jan actually cooking. Let's see, is he gonna survive the effect blocks? Oh, who is this? Elsapat. Oh, did Elsapat go for the... I hope people are not doing the FPS abuse, because it's kind of stupid. But it's actually Purple. Is Purple finalist? No. But Purple is being chased by Nice, who is also not finalist. Snappy also not finalist. So I don't think we will see a winner now. But let's see the rest of the map. We have a very tricky and very bad sausage section. But it is drivable, as I said. And Purple is looking pretty good, actually. And I think he is also going to close it out here. Yes, Purple with the round win. And with that, Purple winning 500 points. And Purple is still a little bit away from finalists. So he is in desperate need of them. But okay, good round by him. Ah, slow-mo exploit only works if it's block mix into a start. Okay, good to know, August. I wish I would have known before. I didn't know that. Okay, second round here. We have the cutters. This is what it looks like. Dropping into the downhill. Oh, purple with a small flip. But Fredwolf getting it pretty good. And Fredwolf is in finalist. And he has a very solid lead, actually. Holy shit, look at this. Fredwolf cooking. Not getting affected by the effects here. But Ice. Ice is chasing him. Ice, of course, also wants that final slot. There is only one more player who is gonna directly qualify. And it seems like it's either gonna be Fredwolf or Ice. So let's see. Oh, but Ice struggling a lot with the gears. The thing is, Fredwolf is already qualified. So if he wins now, he basically denies other people to qualify, which is also worth a lot. He could possibly deny strong opponents. And he has a huge lead. I think he is gonna steal the spot away from the others. Fredwolf getting third today. GG to Fredwolf for basically qualifying again. But now, as I said, very important, guys. Don't leave the server. We still play out the fourth and the fifth place. They will also still close out finalists. And they will win a huge amount of points towards the leaderboard, which is also worth a lot. So we have one more round here. The final one. Which means we will at least see one more map. So let's see what's the next one's gonna be about. We have a lot of people surviving start. Nice, looking really good. We have people going for the standing respawn and people going for the turnaround. It seems like Nice with the turnaround actually has the fastest strat, but not with the greatest speed here. Obi Boy is overtaking. Okay, Obi Boy not in finalist. Oh, but look at this. Nice with a really good jump, jumping very far to the right. Is he going for the nose slide? Yes. Okay, look at this. We have a race this time. Nobody far ahead. Who is gonna manage the gears and the awkward lines the best? Let's see. We have almost a four-man tie. Nice with a little bit of airtime, but therefore a very good line here. Overtaking Obi Boy. And Obi Boy going for airtime here. Getting a clip though. And it is Nice in first. But look at this. Ice is chasing. Could he catch up with a very good last turn? Nice with a nose slide. And it is actually Ice sniping. That is so unfortunate for Nice. Ain't no way. Okay, that is unfortunate. Ice in fourth place, and with that we only have the fifth place to play out. Only one more finalist to to close it out. This time it's actually not that big of a finalist fiesta. We have one more map, at least one more, so let's see what that one is gonna be about. I am a little bit scared because I know that there is at least one more map in the pool, which is very, very bad. And if it's that one coming up, it would be very... Oh, no. It's actually this one. No way. Okay, I'm sorry, guys. This is by far the worst map that I randomized. This is a fragile map, and it is really fucking shit. And already the map name. Scrappy Masterpiece, I swear. This one is fucking horrible. I can tell you that much. This one is horrible as fuck. Skandir left the server. My name is Skandir, and I have no motivation to play this. Fair enough, because this map is really bad. You basically have fragile, you have wet plastic, and you are just completely in the mud, as you can see. I don't know if there is any strat to this. It is literally just a stupid map. I cannot tell you more about it. It is just stupid. It's just luck, I think. And in the ending, we also have a pipe, which is not luck. So you see people are coming in, rather slowly, going onto the pipe, and then you need to still finish, not like Gatito. So yeah, CJ winning the warm-up, very dank map. Let's see what's gonna happen. Is it gonna be one of the finalists or is it not? On this map, it could be basically anyone. Not gonna lie. So let's see. Let's follow it in camera 7 because then we can see who is the furthest at. Of course, everybody crashing like crazy here. I'm not sure if that's even possible to avoid. So who's gonna arrive at the finish the quickest? Is it the people on the right? It seems like it. Oh, Nicolas and Marcel. Marcel with an insane finish. 33.4. Okay, Marcel Town with an insane finish. And Marcel Town was not even... Where the hell is he? Marcel just joined. Oh, yeah, hello? 124th and Marcel won the round. Fantastic. Marcel just joined from server 2 and stole a place on server 1. Banger move. Absolute banger move. Yeah, hello? That is something very interesting to go for. So, we have no brakes, we have fragile. Nice going for something. Was the strat nice or was it not? Hard to tell. Who is in first? It looks like, okay, nice actually cooking. If nice gets the risky finish, he might be able to close it out. You can't just jump like this. You don't, like, it's very easy finish actually. Oh, but nice going for the pipe, but it is also nice closing it out. And with that, we have nice in fifth place. So the positions are Tarpo in first, Marijntje in second, the duo Dutchies. Then we have Fred Wolf, who already qualified last week. So he is basically stealing a spot away. And then nice winning 15,000 points. Ice 15,000 and nice 10,000 points. So yeah, that was it with weekly qualifier number 3 of the month of September. I really hope you enjoyed it. Guys, make sure to not leave the stream yet or the video, because now that the tournament ended, we are gonna roll the styles for the next qualifier. We have a lot of styles in the list, like a lot. I think it's 50 overall, and 60 entries actually. And yeah, we're gonna roll out 3 styles now. We're not gonna reuse styles, so in case I roll slow-mo again, for example, I'm gonna re-roll. So yeah, let's see what it's gonna be. We're gonna roll out style number 1. I'm scared. Let's see. Is it gonna be something normal? Is it gonna be something dank? We will see. It is. Style number 1 is sausage. Okay. Sausage, a pretty normal style. I don't think sausage is something anybody can complain about. I think sausage is absolutely fair. That is not too bad. So let's see what style number 2 is gonna be. I'm scared. What is style number 2? Is it gonna be something normal or not? It is 9999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999 Heath, Marentier, Lars, Tarpor, Fred Wolf, who made it twice technically. And also, yeah, no, that's it. That's the top 8 who are safe, qualified already. And then, just going by points, we have Croxy. I don't know who this is. LEB, PMC. I don't know who it is. Intax, Blef, Snappy, Patenfechter, Arpa, Auris, Seemaus, Jan van Achtern, Dennis, and Flo. But as you can see, you know, Torben, Hagen, Skandir, quite close behind that. So we still have a good fight here. But yeah, guys, this is going to be it for today. I really hope you enjoyed. We will see each other next week again for the Big Yak Monthly Cup. We will see each other tomorrow for the next stream. Hope you enjoyed. Thank you very much for watching, of course.